All right, time for some more Alone in the Dark. First thing you'll probably notice is that the camera is a little bit different this time around, because normally you just see my face. So I think it's time. This is just an experiment. I'm just gonna see how things are. See how this pans out. This is not a permanent thing either. And the first thing I noticed is that there's just a red dot right in my camera, which means I am live. Which I never noticed until now. Did I come from this way? Yeah, I think I did come from this way. I think I was going this way the last time. That tells me I think I am going backwards. Yeah, I think I am going backwards. Okay, so, yeah, I actually was going backwards. I've never been this way before. How she survived that is beyond me. Oh, you're back here. set of technical drawings detailing how parts of Dorsetto will be sealed off. Interesting. Of biscuits. Ooh, yummy. All the world's a stage. Ooh, we got a secret objective. Life is a stage play performed to no one, applauded by no one, and wanted by no one. A story already written, meant to play out in one way only. I wrote my book in order to explain that there might be more to life than free will isn't truly free unless it moves against the expected. In retrospect, I think my ambition was hubristic. Jeremy had a much more humble suggestion. What if we all just went home? So I wonder what the secret objective is. Huh. Oh, something at the desk here. Closing the refuge. I will read this. Closing the refuge, June 17th, 1919. It is with a heavy heart that I must declare the Dorsetto Refuge to be harmful beyond saving. As an emergency hospital, we have, over the last 2 years, treated hundreds of patients suffering the so-called Spanish flu. Unfortunately, our mortality numbers are unforgivable. While the influenza in itself was often successfully treated, many died of fungal infections and suddenly acts of violent madness. Yikes. In order to dismantle the refuge safely, building engineers will survey what parts of the house are especially contaminated by the particular rot discovered by Jean-Baptiste Tabou. The rot is believed to be the main perpetrator in spreading the deadly fungal infection, but also the cause of the incurable madness. The most afflicted rooms will then be sealed permanently to create a cordon sanitaire. As the dead seem to exacerbate the spreading of the fungal infection, all bodies that can't be cremated by tomorrow will be forever entombed inside Dorsetto's sealed section. The refuge was never meant to be permanent, and as the influenza epidemic seems to be in decline, it stands to reason that we shut the facility together. Altogether. Many brave volunteers have helped for very little pay to treat those in need for almost 2 years, and we are forever in their debt. All surviving patients will be transferred to other medical facilities around New Orleans as soon as possible. At the end of the summer, we should be able to leave Dorsetto to recover. Dr. Isaac Herbert. Huh. I've got a chance to explore this room with, Hold on a sec, we're not quite ready yet. Plans A. Hold on a sec here. Find a flaw in the Dorsetto entombment plans to get out. So let's see here, where was this flaw again? Most affected rooms, huh? Wait a second, I wonder if I have to recreate this somehow. Let's see if there's any items I'm missing. Let's see here. Where would this flaw be? This is a new puzzle because I've never done this one before. Match the plan. Yeah, I know that part, but the laboratory was there. And that's right. That's surgery.
Ashamed of myself. Forgive me. Please, John. Let me go.
She didn't want to see him waste away. She adopted a lie because it felt better. It was a hate that man passed away from the city. But she was very proud of the man she made. A man who died a martyr in the trenches of France. This must have been the true trauma that the dog man specified in the contract. But why was it in his and not Jerry?
As I suspected. I get it, you can only use the key once. Huh. It's not like Resident Evil where you can use the same key two, maybe three times. What am I missing here in the... Oh. Toe tag. Okay, so it's like I've said it before here. There are items that, only pertain to Emily and the other one pertain to, Edward. Let's go pay Dr. Gray a visit. Where's his apartment? It's right up there, so... Cut through the dining room instead of going this way. What was I thinking? Oh, I get it. It's a one-way door. Ruth's room is locked, too. Now we're back to this.
Thank you.
I'm here on behalf of your brother Phil.
You were.
I think I read that already here in the previous. Snake dagger, I already know about this. We're gonna need it. Oh yeah, I can take the furniture key to the, whatchamacallit, the wardrobe. I think by this point it would open up to something far more, how you say, interesting, but I guess apparently not. wig. But whatever. Sallow offering. Prisoner of Ice. What can be said about Jacob Van Ostade without evoking contempt or apologia? The first piece of information is the obvious. He is not the explorer Jeremy idolized in his youth, but a figment of his imagination. If you want biographical facts, I am not the one to answer such questions. In the case of Jeremy, he is the guardian of imagination, or rather a persona appointed the role of containing a self-sabotaging mania. However useful Jacob once was, his loyalty to Jeremy has slowly been replaced by fanaticism. Like a firekeeper who has for decades been burnt by his own secret flames, now does what he imagines the fire wants. Jeremy has lost all control over Jacob and suffers greatly because of him, but is admittedly also still invigorated by his labor. In the plainest of words, Jacob keeps Jeremy sick so he can remain Jeremy. Yikes. The Greenland Expedition. Oh, I think I read this in the previous playthrough here, so we're not going to read it again. Borealis again. Where'd he go? Well, that wasn't so hard. Whew. A few flares and a few bullets. Bam, he's dead. I didn't even except for a single hit. So that's good to know. now, the finale.
To see you made it, miss. And all that ruckus, I'd have give you a healthy dose of that sleeping juice. So sure you've been waking up again.
What happened?
You had a psychological breakdown, trying to shoot yourself. Sorry for the manhandling, but just wanted to save you.
You also stabbed Jeremy in the eye.
Is he all right?
He's a little strange, but everything else is back to normal.
Whenever I see the word normal, they really gotta start putting it in quotes. Because, honestly, there is no such thing as normal anymore.
Let's see you standing up.
Jeremy, are you okay? I'm so sorry for hurting you. How can you ever forgive me?
Emily, I missed you so.
Is it anesthesia? He seems so weak.
I wish that was the case. It turns out that you managed to re-autonomize him. It's actually quite impressive considering your technique.
This is permanent?
You sacrificed a piece of his mind to save the whole. It's a little like treating a bad knee by cutting off the leg. It's blunt.
That's terrible.
As we like to call it, a necessary sacrifice.
Jeremy?
Are you? Where did he come? How does he know?
You see, with a violent stab, you make any future treatment quite redundant. I assume you will be bringing him with you back to New Orleans.
I will. I just need to find a thing. you're still going? It's been hours. You forgot this.
Well, I just didn't want you to think we abandoned.
Can we go home?
Yes, please. Can we?
What? You guys didn't like the play?
It was all right. A little difficult to follow.
Oh, I agree. Let's just say there are moments where it left me alone in the dark.
Oh, God.
That's product placement.
Whoa, what do you know?
Did you like it, sweetie?
There should have been a hedge maze.
A hedge maze?
Uh-huh. Pirates. That would have been fun.
Well, maybe next time.
Wait. That's it? That's it? Well, I guess that's... Huh. Wait. We're not done yet. Not by a long shot here. No. We're not done yet. We gotta go back, and we're gonna finish this. Alright, instead of talking to all the yahoos here, we're just gonna go ahead and get right to the finale. I wonder if I went back to New Game Plus and played as Carnby, I wonder if I could get Grace a toy to play with and have the same ending as before like I did just a few moments ago with M. Again, except from Em's perspective.
What are you doing? This is madness.
This heals me.
She's just a child.
Okay. Yes, you have to finish this year because apparently, Christ almighty. Well, it also doesn't help the fact that I have only one drink. Like I said before, the first part of the fight's not that difficult. It's the second part that gets ya. Watch this whole thing. I'm just stupid. I'm surprised you just can't skip it. Come on. Oh, this is unreal. Oh my flipping God. Lord. If I had more drink, this probably been beaten already, but nope. What good is a brick gonna do? Nothing. But yeah, like this is real fair. the end of that. Whew. God, that's done. Now, once again, they are one big happy family. That's pretty much it. I mean, there's literally nothing else left. Yeah, there's like really not much left to talk here. Yeah, there's nothing else left. So I guess that's it. Yeah. And as far as doing the new Plus game goes, gosh, I don't know. You know what? Starting a new game plus with all weapons unlocked, deadlier combat, and some new surprises. Gosh, I don't know. You know what? I'll sit on this one here. I'll think on this. But and nonetheless, though, here, this takes care of Emily's side of the story. Thank you to those who watched. I'll see you all next time, I guess.